Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Underground Examination. For this episode, I'm your host, Stuart the Nighthawk Hawkins, and with me is Mr. Jashaun Peele, sax player extraordinaire and educator. Mr. Peele, welcome to the show.
Thank you. Appreciate it, man.
Glad to have you. So tell me, sir, how did this CD come about?
Well, pretty much what ended up happening was my mom, I tell this story all the time, man. My mom gave me a deadline, and she was like, you know, hey, this is what I need, this is when I need it, and so this is what needs to happen. And I was like, okay, Mom. And this was last year, and she said, you know, I want to do something March 19th. I said, well, you know what? I've been saying that I'm going to have an album out at the beginning of the year of 2016. Let's go ahead and keep that promise and let that be the album release. So, you know, not only did she kind of expedite it time-wise, but just personally, I felt like it was time. You know what I'm saying? I mean, you know, my love for music has grown tremendously and from where it was. And I did an EP last year. And so, you know, from there, things kind of, it kind of grew, man. And after that, it was like, you know, after the EP dropped and it was such a fun thing to record, I was like, man, I got to go in and, you know, give the people 10 more tracks. And so, because, I mean, the EP was only 5. So I went in and rocked out with some great producers and great guys that I'm able to call friends who are also musicians. And so, you know, it was just a fun time, man, just making it happen.
Well, I think the CD is great, and I enjoy listening to it myself personally.
I appreciate it.
And besides your mother, who are some of the other, who or what were some of your other inspirations for doing the CD?
Well, just the guy that taught me how to play the horn, you know what I'm saying? I mean, Mr. Pritchett, great man, great guy. And he took time out of his schedule to sit down with me and say, hey, listen, you know, if you have this passion for it and if you want to, you know, learn how to play the horn, I'll show you. As long as you are interested in it, I'll show you. Once you lose interest, then, hey, I can't help you anymore. You know, which was respected. And I started playing when I was 7. And so, you know, like I tell people all the time, horn's bigger than me almost, you know. And it took a lot of wind to go through that thing to make it produce a note. But nevertheless, you know, he helped me. Outside of him, just all my family that have pushed me. My fiance who stood beside me and pushed me and, you know, kind of been that driving force as well. You know, just everybody who has contributed something to my life. You know what I'm saying? They have they have definitely pushed me and helped me to get to where I am and to be able to sit down and say, hey, if you love this so much, then make it happen. You know, and a buddy of mine who's also one of the producers on the album, when we went into the studio, the first question he asked, he said, man, I know this isn't a bucket list thing for you. Like some people produce an album just to write off their bucket list. And then they never, you know, touch music anymore for the rest of their lives. But for me, you know, it was a thing of, hey, this is my jump. This is my leap of faith. You know what I'm saying? I want to know, you know, what will happen or what could possibly happen, you know, after this comes out and comes about. And just I want to leave my stamp on the world. And this is my beginning of, you know, making my stamp. So, yeah.
Well, that's awesome. Well, you know, one of the things I've always had a bit of a problem with is that I hear a lot of people say that, you know, they want to do this or they want to do that, but. Mm-hmm. And so to squash a few of those but, were there any obstacles or any things out there that were hindering you from completing this project?
Oh, indeed. And I knew going into it that I was going to hit some bumps. You know what I'm saying? I didn't know what the bumps were, but I knew I was going to hit some bumps. And, I mean, one of the obvious bumps was the financial burden that comes along with, you know, producing an album. You know, it's not cheap. You know, and luckily,
of course.
Right, you have to invest in yourself. That's the main thing. And once you invest in yourself, then that shows others that, hey, you're really serious about this and about what you're trying to do. And so, you know, luckily I was able to just financially, I was able to get some help and see my way through that part. But not only that, but also time. You know, some nights and some days and you have writer's block. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
you sit down and try and write a song and make it happen, it's like I can't formulate, you know, the melody line or whatever. Mm-hmm. So it's that taking place, and once that takes place, then you have to then you have to space out the increments of days that you had to record. So just outside of just the financial side of things and time, you know, that those, in my personal opinion, those were the two hurdles. And luckily I cleared them and was able to get all the tracks that I wanted on the album and in a timely manner, even though I did have to drive up to Pennsylvania and go get the CDs that I had ordered, because they weren't gonna be back in time for the release. You know what I mean? But I drove up that Friday, got them, came back home that Friday, came back to Grand Rapids, and you know, they were ready for Saturday. But you know, it was one of those things where this was definitely a learning experience. It was definitely a learning experience, and I'm glad I went through it though.
Any problems with naysayers?
Well, you're always gonna have that. You know?
Yeah,
you're always gonna have that.
Too
man.
True.
It's funny because, you know, I don't mind telling people quick that I know I'm not the best saxophone player out there. You know, I know there are plenty of guys that sound better than me, and there are guys that I know personally that sound better than me. And you know, my thing is, I respect their craft and I respect what they do. You know, and I just, you know, regardless of how people feel about me and what they think of me as a person and even of my music, you know, I still want them to just respect my craft. That's all, you know what I'm saying? And I mean, you know, my take on music may not be another man's take on music, but just let that be my perspective and let me, you know, hold on to my perspective and, you know, put my perspective out there, because what you're doing is you're putting your perspective out there.
That's right.
So, you know, I just ask that people, you know, respect my perspective. And I mean, I've had, you know, friends and other colleagues that have, you know, said to me, hey, listen, we don't need you, you know what I'm saying? You're not gonna be successful just off how you look or how you act, you know what I mean? And so those have always been interesting comments to hear, you know what I mean?
Too true.
Yeah.
So we're coming up on one of the songs on your CD, so what are you gonna play for us?
This first tune I'm gonna play is No Boundaries. It's the title cut of the album. The album is called No Boundaries, and it was a fun tune to record. You know, it was funny, I promised some people back 2 years ago that me and a buddy of mine were gonna go into a studio, we're gonna make a song, and lo and behold, that's exactly what we did. You know, we went in, we talked about some ideas, and next thing you know, here we are with No Boundaries, man. So it was fun though. It was
awesome. So why don't you get that one for us, and I'm looking forward to hearing it again. So Mr. Jashaun Peele doing No Boundaries. Awesome, awesome. My brother, you cannot stop there. You got to give us one more, man.
Come on. One more? Okay, cool.
We gotta get one more, man.
Come on. You
gotta
got it, man, bro. You
gotta get another.
You definitely got it. That'll work.
Yeah. Oh yeah. And what's the name of this one?
The name of this one is Freedom Cruising.
All right, Freedom
Cruising.
Yeah,
Freedom Cruising. This is my mom's favorite tune.
Uh-oh. Then you gotta play that one, my brother.
Exactly.
Oh yeah. Appreciate it, man. That was wonderful. Oh, man. Okay, I got to know. How long have you been playing, my man?
Oh, man. Well, I guess now I'll be telling my age, but it doesn't matter because I'm a guy. Now.
Hey, there you go.
But like I said, I started when I was 7, so I've been playing for like 22, 23 years, man.
Wow.
I
mean,
awesome. I'll be 29. I just turned 29 in January, but... But, yeah, so, I mean, you know,
along with this age has come some interesting journeys, you know, via music.
I understand.
You know what I mean? And so yeah, you know, like I say, it was bigger than me when I started out, but stuck with it. You know, the man, he was a deacon at my church. He showed me how to play the horn, mm-hmm. showed me how to hold it, all the good stuff. And then went on to middle school, Mr. Montre Freeman. He looked out for me and he carried me from middle school all up to high school, learned the rest there. And then I got to college and decided I wanted to take up math instead of music.
So okay. Yeah, man. All right. So you did play in high school band and things of that nature?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. I did.
And
yeah.
How was that for you?
It was fun. You know, marching band is always fun. You know, playing tunes that you hear on the radio.
Yeah.
So,
doubt.
You know, that's always fun, man. And just being able to see that stuff, mm-hmm. you know, on a piece of sheet music makes a difference than just hearing it. You know what I mean? Because I play by ear a lot, but whenever you're able to see those notes on sheet music, you appreciate it a little more. Mm. You know what I mean?
True. And, very true.
And just understand the theory behind the music, mm-hmm. you know, and not just being able to listen to it and play it, but more so how did it originate and how does it look on paper and all that good stuff. So yeah, man.
That's awesome. That is awesome. So do you play any other instruments other than saxophone, or do you have any other saxes other than your alto?
Yes, well, to answer the first question, I'm still trying to learn how to play sax. So, so you know, it's one of them things where
you're one of the better students I've ever heard.
Oh, man, appreciate it, bro.
All right.
Appreciate it, man. But I do play alto. I do play tenor.
Okay.
At one point, I did play barre, but I took that and sold that. But I love alto. I've been playing it the longest, and just in the more recent years, I picked up a tenor and started trying to matriculate through that. You know, and mm-hmm. I mean, it has a different voicing, obviously. So,
definitely.
You know, along with that different voicing comes, different concepts. You know what I'm saying? Because you hear something, but then whenever you play it, it sounds better sometimes playing it on alto, and vice versa. Sometimes
true,
you play a lick
true.
On alto, but it sounds better playing it on tenor. So, you know, it's always interesting just to get that concept of being a alto player or being a tenor player.
Too true.
Yeah.
Too true. Wow, that's awesome. So tell me, who are some of your musical influences?
Well, like I told you, outside the guy that taught me how to play, you know, he's definitely one of them. But then outside of him, you know, you got going back, you got Cannonball, you know.
Cannonball Adderley?
Oh, yeah, for sure, man.
You really?
Know, definitely. He's definitely in the rotation.
Wow,
you know
same
what I'm
here. My instructor moved me towards him when I first started playing.
Oh, yeah.
Wow, that's impressive.
Yeah, man. So, I mean, you know, you take it back, you're going back to him, you're going back to Charlie, you got, you know what I'm saying, Coltrane, all mm-hmm. them doing their thing. But outside of Miles as well, of course. You know, but, I mean, kind of more up-to-date people that's doing their thing now is you have, you know, a technician like Gerald Albright. You got, mm-hmm. you know, just a melodic soul through Kirk Whalum. You know what I'm saying?
Definitely.
So, I mean, you
definitely.
Know, he can take a melody and just make that joint just speak to life, you know, and bring it to life, you know. And so it's always good to hear those guys play, listen to those guys play. You know, even, I mean, you give, the list can go on, you know what I mean? Yep. You got Najee, you got, you know, a lot of cats out here doing their thing, man. And,
I understand,
you know,
I
respect them all and appreciate the things that they've done and just the paths that they're starting to blaze and have blazed. For us, you know, and for us younger musicians to come behind and try and pick up that torch, you know.
Yeah, they're all great, and I apologize for trying to put you on the spot by trying to name a few like that.
Oh, that's all good.
That's wrong, because they're all awesome. You're absolutely right. They
yeah.
are all inspirations for everybody.
Indeed, indeed.
For everybody who want to go after that craft.
And there's
awesome.
Thousands more, you know what I'm saying?
You know,
they definitely
you know it.
Just
you
can't
know
get
it.
Named.
So are you touring now, or?
Well, at the moment, I am working on some things. So I'm trying to put some dates together and some locations and
awesome.
I'm in some different cities and try to make some things happen because, you know, obviously I want people to hear more of this album. You know, the last song I just played, Freedom Cruising, isn't on the album. It's on my EP that I released last summer. that I had mentioned previously. But, you know, like I said, it's just one of those things where I want to get out there more, you know, and let people be able to hear me and just enjoy what I enjoy. You know what I mean? I want to show them how much of a fun time I like to have on stage and jamming with my guys and, you know, jamming with my band. I mean, awesome group of guys, and, you know, they're all very talented musicians, you know, and so it's just, that's what I want to bring to every city that I touch, you know, and every heart that I touch as well, you know, so.
Well, we definitely want to help you get out there. And as a matter of fact, it's time to hear you blow a little mobile for us, bro.
Cool deal, man.
All right.
I appreciate it.
All right.
And this next song we got is, it's funny, it's Silencio y Escucha. So that's the name of it.
Thank you very much. Because when I showcased your CD on my show,
right,
I didn't know how to pronounce that. Yeah. I did not want to touch that.
I understand,
but you,
man,
go ahead and knock it out, my brother.
Yeah, man, it's a fun tune, and it's one of those things where I tell people all the time, there are certain things that sound better in other languages.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying?
Definitely.
And Silencio Escucha means pretty much, you know, silence and listen. You know what I mean? So, you know, whether you know, you have to be silent and listen in your relationship with your mate or your significant other, you know, it works the same way as even unto God.
That's,
you know,
a part of life.
So,
man.
Yeah, exactly.
It really is.
Exactly.
It's a part of life.
So that's what it's
so
all
let's
about.
Hear it, bro.
Yeah, bro.
All right.
Yeah. Appreciate it, man.
I love it, man. I love it.
Awesome, love it. Awesome, brother.
Oh, well, we mentioned about touring. What are some of the places you want to go? Where are some of the places you would like to perform in?
Well, outside of just here in the States, you know, you got up and down the East Coast. You know, you got Blues Alley, you got Birchmere, between D.C. and in Virginia, go south, you got Cat's Cradle down in Atlanta. You know, you have
the teacher coming out.
Yeah, man, yeah. As soon as you hear it, you know you gotta correct yourself. Somebody else will. But you know, it's a lot of different places, you know, that
overseas?
Oh, most definitely. Most definitely. You know, you got I forgot the name of it, but I know it's over in Tokyo, in Japan. You know, you got places over in Australia. Mm. You know, you definitely got the Montreal Jazz Festival.
Oh, yeah.
You know, so, you know, all those big things like that, man. You know, so it's the Jakarta. Mm-hmm. You know, the Java Jazz Festival, all that. So, you know, different places like that that I know love jazz. You got Germany, you got Denmark. You know, and just all of those places love music, you know, general. And it's, you know, you'll hear many musicians say it, that, you know, they can go over to a country in Europe and just enjoy themselves a little much more. And it's nothing to throw any kind of shade against those that are here in America and those patrons that come out to enjoy music in America, but it's just a different enjoyment, you know, that they have. And so just to get over in those places to be able to experience that, you know, just be awesome. You know what I mean?
That's great.
And would love to be in that opportunity, you know.
Well, I said myself, I see you on a smooth jazz cruise, man. I'm telling you.
Well, I appreciate it, brother.
I see appreciate it. It. I see it. You headlining your own show.
I definitely receive it.
All right. So if any other brothers out there, or sisters, I should say, are out there trying to put their own CD together, do you have any advice for them?
Stay true to yourself. You know, whenever you go in and whenever you ask people to help you on stuff, sometimes their vision for who you are can get translated instead of your vision for who you are gets translated just with their help. You know, you ask for their expertise in certain things, but, you know, I tell people
ultimately
all the time.
You.
Right, you know, yeah. And I tell people quick, you know, hey, look, whenever you write something, don't write it thinking you're writing it for a saxophonist. Like, that's not the sound that I'm going for. That's not the sound that I want. You know, I want it to be a thing of where, yes, it's musical, and, you know, it is appreciated by the jazz lovers and fellow musicians, because, you know, a lot of times you want to get that appreciation from your peers. You know, that means a lot, you know, because they're in the same genre you're in, or they're in the same mindset you're thinking, and all that good stuff. But, you know, now it's like, you know, I ask people quick, hey, you know, just give me something that's more along the lines of, you know, something you would write for a dope R&B artist, mm-hmm. you know, or even something that would go gospel, that you could go gospel with, or, you know, whatever, because it is the feel of the music, but I don't want it to be so to the point where it's, you know, smooth jazz and it's 90s smooth jazz and, you know, what used to be smooth jazz. Mm-hmm. You know, I want to be the curve. I don't want to be behind the curve.
I understand.
You know what I mean? I want to be the curve. So, you know, just this next album, me and a buddy of mine, we've already been talking about some things and just mapping some things out musically, so that way we can make it happen, man, because this next album is just going to be way more musical. It's going to have a lot more stuff on it. We're going to start cranking it up in summertime this summer, you know, so we're going back in and going back in the studio and knocking some more stuff out so we can have another album to sit here and talk about, man.
All right. I look forward to that.
Yeah, man. So it's exciting. Like I said, the first album was definitely a learning experience, and mm-hmm. it was definitely a thing of, you know, I had fun doing it, enjoyed doing it, loved doing it, but it's also still time to make more music, you know?
That's right.
Yeah.
Well, that's about all the time we have for today. And once again, I'd like to thank my guest, Mr. Jashaun Peele. Enjoyed you, brother.
Appreciate it, man.
You got to give us one more before you leave, though.
Oh, you know it. You know
it. All right. Yes, here he is again.
And this song right here is Take My Hand, and it's also on the album. And you can purchase the album at mkt.com/JP on sax. That's mkt.com/JP on sax. Thank you.